Hot in there. You look at him.
No! I just had him, boys. Are you freaking serious? What is up, everybody? Hope y'all are having a great day, a great quarantine, whatever time y'all are watching this here. Sorry for that bad lighting. Hope it's a great one. I don't know if y'all saw that earlier right there, but we were taking that little dandy thing down to a little pond right there and doing some pond fishing today. Got all the rigs right here. I'll get into that more when we get into the pond here, but all right, I'm gonna start getting biking and let's get it. What is up? We are at the spot we are fishing right now. Just pulled up, got my friend Logan over there fishing. Hopefully we can get on a good bite here. Like I saw, you saw those rigs. I got a Texas rig tied up, I got a frog. Probably gonna put on a swim jig or normal jig. Weightless wacky rig. Over there he has just a weightless worm. And yeah, let's get into it. Been fishing here for a few minutes here. We're just working the banks, trying to find some fish that are in the shallow here. We have a creek over here, and I'll pan over to that creek right now. But that has moving water, and it's been, there's a bluegill bed right by it, and there's a bass all over that, and hopefully we can get some bites doing that. So, yeah. Cheese and rice, dude.
We'll go too.
I got one. Oh!
Did you?
Yeah, I did. Just had one, boys.
You sure it was on that tree?
Hey, you want to do a little challenge? We can make it a little interesting for y'all staying home there. Some of y'all are in quarantine, I know that, and I'm very sorry for y'all who are still in quarantine, because that's tough. Because I'm in Georgia and I'm very blessed to have a state that has opened up. Well, actually, I've been able to fish the whole quarantine. But now I'm being able to fish with friends like Logan and not having to be able to stay like home. All right, so what do you want to do? Like, biggest fish, most fish? I'll jump in. Loser jumps in.
Yeah, I got a bathing suit on.
Yeah, so do I. Hey, it's summer vibes, exactly. It's summer vibes. You got to get that bathing suit vibe on.
I think Ben has one right now.
Perfect.
You got a hook set?
Yeah.
Shoot!
He had a knife, probably two. Okay.
Gee whiz, boys. Look at that kid.
Okay, we're gonna go weigh it. Probably. This little junior right here.
Yeah. Probably about a little, I don't know, 1.5, 2, maybe. Maybe. Wanted some change, I know that. Yeah, 1.5 exactly. So, there you go. Good little way to start the fish.
Like third cast?
Yep.
Beautiful bass.
Releasing this sweet old girl right here. Let's get it, baby. All right, so we got these Strike King KVD Senkos right here. A little green pumpkin action. That's what I caught those fish on. And I got my soft plastic bag here. I'll leave this link in the description, though, but it's Goosey Squad's money bag. It's an amazing bag where you can put all your soft plastics. So hopefully we can get on more bites, and let's get it going. So we're at the next pond here. If you can see right here, there's two ponds. So right here, there's that one pond. And then right here, there's this other.
I'll be right back.
Just saw a big old boil right here.
We just saw a big old blow up over here. We're gonna go ahead to it.
Yeah.
Haven't had too much action at this pond here, but hopefully we can get it. I'm fishing with Guggen Bait's Mondo Worm, and he's fishing there down there with KVD's Green Pumpkin Senko.
Not anymore. It came off.
Rip. It came off. Never mind. Well, look at that junior down there. No worm, just fishing for bluegill. I can dweeb.
I have a piece of worm.
Yeah, funny thing, actually. Yesterday, I caught this giant bluegill on a 4-aught size hook and just a baby piece of worm.
It looked almost just like this, except a smaller worm.
Yep, exactly like that. Like, what are you doing in your life when you're just fishing for a bluegill with a bass hook? I don't know if I already told y'all this, but we're doing a little challenge here. 1v1 challenge with this little lady back there and a little blue hat right there.
Lady?
Yeah, see, that's why he took off his hat, because he knows he's a lady. Jeez, and Rice, this man tried to cast on me. Anyways, we're doing a little 1v1 challenge here. Probably going to be on the pond here for about, I don't know, 2 or 3 hours. And what are we doing? What are we doing? Biggest bass or most?
Biggest.
So we're doing biggest bass, y'all. Biggest bass wins. And all right, see you later.
Ben's out. We're both trying to get this fish that I just missed, sadly.
Yeah. Because he knows he's gonna lose.
No. Ben's gonna be jumping in the pond later.
Got him. I got him.
I lied.
Milk. Jeez. This kid's running like a sweet potato. Look at this little kid. Look at Junior back here. Look at this kid. What's he doing biting on a 10-inch worm? My worm's almost as long as him. What's he doing? Hey, chill, Junior. Chill, Junior. Chill. All right. What you doing there? Yeah. Hey!
He caught the little shrimp. That's Ben's PB right there.
Nah, it's not, but it's just a little dink, but I don't think that's gonna win the challenge, but hey, he's a fish.
Better than what I've gotten. Back, just fishing this bank real quick, trying to get a nice little bass. See what we have to work with.
He's down 2-0.
There should be catfish, carp.
Oh, we're doing any fish?
Bass and bluegill in the pond.
Oh, any fish wins. Any fish, the biggest fish wins. Any fish. Sorry for the car noise. We're kind of at somebody's house. Not illegally, don't worry, kids. But, nice friends of ours that my relatives are friends of, letting us fish this pond. It's kind of a big fish pond. I mean, it's kind of like on and off. I know people have caught sevens. I know they stocked a 10 in here, so hopefully we can get some big bites and run into some big ones here. It being the middle of the day, I know whoever's watching this, it may not be where y'all are watching this, but what I'm fishing right now is in the middle of the day, and what I'm fishing with is this big worm, and for people down south, it's kind of already summertime right now. It's that big worm right there. It's called a Guggen Bates Mondo worm, and being in the middle of the day, they're probably not going to hit moving baits or topwater. It's definitely possible. Don't get me wrong. It's definitely possible. Most of the time, you do want to slow it down and try to hit at the bottom in the middle of days. Like a lot of times in the morning will be a good topwater bite close to dark time because of the light. For new kids that don't know too much about bass fishing, bass don't have eyelids, and so they're more active when there's less light. So low light conditions will be most likely where they're gonna be more active.
Or in shade.
Yeah, or if you have shade lines. A big thing with, especially if you're fishing big lakes, if there's these big, like, layers of, like, this dam that will make a big drop-off.
Lay down.
Or laydowns, that's another good thing with shade. Under trees, if y'all are more advanced people that know how to skip under trees, that would be a good thing. And dog. Oh!
That?
He just had one.
It was right there.
He just had a giant right there. Oh, my gosh. Look at this kid. Jeez, nice. Man, just had a giant. Your drag is screaming. All I saw was a white belly take off. I just saw a white belly take off. Like I said, there's some big ones in here.
I did not expect that. I was like, literally right there.
Right there, man. It's like bed fishing.
With glasses on, I could have seen it.
Yeah, I was like, I saw it.
Yeah, I took mine off.
I saw the belly of it. I didn't see the actual. What fish it was. You could have ran into a catfish that had been in the grass. All right, guys, so we just pulled up to this spot, and crazy thing is, I see a fish on a bed. And what I try to do is I pull off, because you definitely do not want to scare your fish when they're on bed. You do not want to get too close and make them alert. And so what you want to do is you want to back off and just let them circle back on the bed, and then you can catch them. Hopefully, we'll try to catch this fish, and yeah. He's turning on me. He might eat. Yep. See, the problem is with bed fishing, all they want to do when they're bed fishing is just take it off their bed. Yeah, that's all they want to do. It's so hard to hook your fish. They'll just barely bite it and then leave it. Look at that. Absolute destroyed my worm. I'm going to have to go get a new one. God dang.
Hey, we could fix that bed wherever.
Oh, easily. All right, we're trying to get Logan on this bed fish here. Well, I mean, I'd love him to catch it, but also I wouldn't because I don't know how big it is, and we're trying to do this 1v1 challenge, so it may not be good, but we're both trying to get this bed fish here. It's crazy how there's one still bedding in. Try to get him mad there. He didn't want that though. Watch this. Imagine top of the roof.
Oh, that was bad.
Y'all northerners that are just starting to get in the spawn, a little tip here for spawners. Well, sometimes, if you have really dingy water, a good bait can use, and it doesn't have to be a lizard right here, but can be a white lizard like that, or just anything white. It's like Guggen Baits, I know, makes a white bandito bug, which is like a white-style creature bait. And the good thing is, I know it's not natural looking, but you can see it in the water well enough, which is what the situation I'm dealing with right now, because we have a little dingy water down here in Georgia. But that'll be good. Situation here, y'all. Like I said earlier, we're trying to fish for this dead fish right now. And so, like I said, I was fishing with this white lizard and Logan, and I got him fired up, like so fired up, and he ate it and I ripped it out of his mouth like a dweeb. But Logan put on a natural color and he went right for it. Like I'm talking right for it. So what I'm going to do is do exactly what he did and put on that natural color that she may like, or he or she may like better, and get that fish, baby.
I started bleeding in 3 spots.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I hooked myself 3 times in a row.
That's fishing for you, ladies and gentlemen.
And others.
Yeah, I'm good with having those people on my channel.
I can still see this channel.
Holy crap. Ooh, he hated this. Oh my gosh. He just hit that thing like a freight train. Holy Bugs Bunny.
Yeah, he ate mine twice. And it was too big for him, probably.
Had a big fish.
He hated it. Oh, he's gonna eat it. There's no way he does it.
Move it right over.
Really? You suck. Don't you love it when your friend boot gangs your bed fishing carrier? He's probably like, what is happening? Come on. Oh, it's going hot. going? Are you freaking serious on the natural color lizard? Are you
just saying come back? Give me a second, come back.
Joking me right now. I just had him. I could have been in the lead with three fish and the biggest fish. Golly.
I don't know if he'll bite again. We're not going to have to swim.
He might have dipped.
Bro.
No way if he just got hooked with that lizard, he's going to bite it. He's going to be very more stingy now. Watch this. He's not going to bite this for the dookie. We're going to have to switch baits.
See, after you hook one after a while, they're most likely going to be smart and not eat this. So what I'm going to do is change up to just a normal Senko or maybe a creature bait. That might work, creature bait.
That could be a ticket right there. What do you do that?
Little beaver style bait right there.
Could be a ticket.
You thought I had him, didn't you?
Yeah. I thought I had him, boys.
I thought Luke was barely in his mouth. I'm like, oh, maybe not.
I mean, he didn't want to fully eat it. You know what I mean? That's bed fishing for you. Bed fishing can help you learn so much. Ladies and gentlemen, because, like, you can see how long sometimes it takes fish to just really get dialed into your lure. Like, you'll just be so disappointed, but sometimes it just takes cast and cast, so don't give up.